Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Westcoat's virtual demo on the Texture-Crete solar reflective finish and Texture-Crete wood finish. We'll also go over the stamp it systems. Today, our presenter is Mark Dezino, who is our regional sales manager for SoCal and Hawaii. On set, we also have Mike Pittman, who is our application specialist. My name is Mallory Cavening. I will be the co-presenter, and Victoria Strock will be our moderator. So before we get started, a little bit of information about Westcoat. Westcoat's been manufacturing flooring systems from San Diego, California for over 30 years. We've used the West in Westcoat to define the four different categories of systems that we offer. So you'll see the WP, the EC, the SC, and the TC. The WP in the top left corner stands for waterproofing. We have a full line of waterproofing systems over plywood and concrete. The EC is the epoxy coat line, and we have a full line of industrial epoxies and decorative epoxies. The SC is our concrete stains and sealers, or surface coat line, and that would be clear sealers and translucent stains. And the TC is our texture coat line, which is what we'll dive into more today, and it's a new textured overlays that you can use over new or existing concrete. So to expand on those systems just a little bit more, in the WP line, the waterproofing line, we have the matte coat system, which is our waterproofing over concrete, and then the ALX system, which is our waterproofing over plywood. This here is two examples of some pretty commonly used systems in our epoxy coat line, which would be our thin film system. These can come in a water-based version or 100% solids, but again, some pretty typical uses here you can see on the screen. Under our SC or surface coat line, you will see a picture in the top left corner of our grind, stain, and seal. And then the bottom right corner is a polished finish. Now the texture coat line is what we'll talk about today. And to expand on these systems just a little bit more, today we will be talking about the Texture-Crete. And the finish we're going to show you today is the Texture-Crete solar reflective finish. We will also go through our stamp it system. And something we're not going to discuss today, but again is a pretty popular install, is our Texture-Crete interior finish. Once again, before we jump in to the live presentation with Mark, what we're gonna do is just go over a little bit of prep for the concrete surface itself. Before you install any type of coating onto a concrete surface, you really wanna make sure that you inspect the concrete. And with that, we are looking for a minimum of 28 days cured. Now, this is an industry standard number. It could take longer for a concrete substrate to cure, to receive a coating. So if that is the case, we definitely want to make sure that we're just being aware of that. Moisture emissions should be less than 5 pounds per 1,000 square feet or less than 75% relative humidity. Typically in an exterior space, we are not going to test for this, but definitely if you're going to be in an interior space, a moisture test is something that you'll want to have done on your project. The concrete should be a minimum of 2,500 PSI. That is going to go across the board on all of these systems that we talked about today. And the concrete should be free of grease, paint, any type of debris or foreign material that would prevent proper adhesion. This is a nice little pie chart that shows reasons why coatings fail. And you can see here that 73% of the reasons that a coating could fail is due to poor substrate preparation and an insufficient bond. So next to that is going to be excessive moisture, and then a poor install at 5%. So again, the prep is really important when we talk about any of these coating systems that you would put over concrete. So definitely surface prep is something that's really something to pay attention to. This is the CSP or Concrete Surface Prep Guideline that is put out by the International Concrete Repair Institute, or ICRI. This is something that we do include in our specifications. If you open up a Westcoat spec, under preparation, it will talk about a CSP number, concrete surface prep. Depending on what system you are putting down, we'll call out for each type of prep that you see here on the screen. The thicker the coating that goes on top is going to require more prep. So you'll see a CSP 6 is a pretty aggressive prep, or a CSP 1 is something that's going to receive a very thin clear sealer. For a CSP 1 to 2, we're typically talking about water blasting in exterior spaces. For a CSP 2 to 3, we are going to look at diamond grinding. And then a CSP 3 to 5, we would look at shot blasting. Now here's a picture on the right-hand side of water blasting. So if we are prepping the concrete using water blasting or pressure washing to receive a coating, you actually want to make sure that you are etching the concrete itself. So So on the right-hand side, you can kind of see the pattern that the pressure washer has created. And this allows a profile for, say, the Texture-Crete system that we're going to talk about today to adhere to. Now, diamond grinding would be used if we need a little bit more prep on a surface. And this is an example, a video of how a diamond grinder works. So you can see the machine underneath has metal abrasives that go underneath the machine, and they go in a circular motion so that they can actually hit all the surface of the concrete and make sure that you get a good, even surface prep. Now, shot blasting would be done if we are putting material on that is going to be a little bit thicker. So say the Texture-Crete system that we'll go over first could require a pressure wash or grinding. When we get into the stamp-it system that we will do at the end, a shot blasting machine would be what you want to use for prep here. And you can see on the screen that there's tiny metal beads that shoot down at the ground, and it actually collects the dust up into the machine as well. So that's the red that you see on the screen. And so this is a dustless machine that can be used. Last item we'll talk about real quick for prep is crack patch. So this is a video that can be found in our training videos, but we did want to break it out for this presentation. And you'll see that the crack should be routed out with a crack chaser, and then our EC72 epoxy gel should be used to patch the crack. The fiberlath would be put down first, and then you can put the EC72 into the fiberlath. But you definitely want to make sure that you broadcast sand onto the top of the patch so that the coating will adhere to it after. We'll go ahead and hand it off to Mark and start our live demo. Once again, thank you for joining us today and have a great day.
Well, hello. My name is Mark Dizzino. I'm the Westcoat architectural rep for Southern California. As Mallory mentioned, I handle San Diego proper, right up into Orange County, the Inland Empire, the desert, the high desert, all the way through to Southern Nevada. And I'm lucky enough to handle Hawaii. Been working in this industry for 31 years. So started in, 1988. Really haven't found a way to get out of this business. So I'm still in this business. I work for, three companies in that entire span, and coming back to work for this company in 2001. I've been here since. So a little bit about Westcoat. We have where we're broadcasting from right now. This virtual presentation is a 50,000 square foot facility in San Diego. I may know many of you on this virtual demo. If I don't, it's very nice to meet you. To continue the introductions, thank you, Mallory. Victoria and Amanda's here doing video and images. Arguably, the most important person in the room right now would be Mike Pittman, who I've known for 25 years in this industry, because without Mike here today, none of this is going to get done properly. So excellent applicator, installer of these coating systems. What I'm going to cover today, to reiterate, is our Texture-Crete systems. Texture-Crete is a brand that we have for concrete coating systems. Very specifically, we're going to cover the Texture-Crete standard with a solar reflective finish, which is a top coat that we've developed over the course of years that keeps your surface 20 to 30% cooler, really pushing this in the hot climate areas, the desert, Arizona, Las Vegas, for instance. And it's working phenomenally well. So we're going to move from that into the Texture-Crete with a wood plank type finish. And it's something that's actually really easy to accomplish. And we're going to cover this step by step. I'm going to show you the things to do. Beyond that, we're going to finish with our stamp overlay. We call it Stamp It, which is a quarter inch stampable overlay. And it's very, very decorative when the concrete is complete. So I want to continue on what Mallory brought to the surfaces, surface prep, and talking about CSP, concrete surface profile. This is where, and you saw the slide that Mallory put up that shows 72% of coating failure is really wrapped around and associated to lack of preparation. And working to get our product specified on residential to include multifamily housing, single family housing, commercial work, interior, exterior. We do a lot of waterproof deck coatings. And I mention that because these finishes can also be used on the waterproof deck coating systems that we offer. So keeping that in mind, if you sat through the WP waterproofing demo that Bill England did, or the EC demo that Mark Hain did, these finishes can be used on the WP systems. Really separates us from most of the waterproof deck coating systems in the industry, which is very nice. ICRI has created this concrete surface profile to be recognized really in specification. If you think about how this came about, years ago we had our spec sheets that said concrete must be clean, etched, porous. And I'm holding up these pads. I don't know if you can see these. If you could feel what these are pads that are tangible evidence to what CSP is. The first one is CSP1. And quite honestly, this feels like 150 grit sandpaper. CSP2, about 120. CSP3, maybe 80 grit sandpaper, et cetera, et cetera. CSP4 is about 50 grit sandpaper. These actually can be purchased. I think you can find them online. Is that correct? I carry one with me all the time because when I have one of my contractors or our contractors that we work with, that there may be a disbonding issue or a delamination issue. And what we hear is your coating is failing. What you did is failing. And the word fail, the alleged failure, actually. Well, we show up and we investigate. So you need to be prepared is my suggestion. Pro tip, number one, show up prepared. We can lay this down on the concrete and look at the actual profile of the concrete and what was specified, more importantly, what's on the Westcoat specification sheet for this particular system. So when it comes to Texture-Crete systems, we're talking about a CSP of 2 to 3. The Stamp-It, it's a little heavier bodied system, quarter inch. We want a CSP 3 or 4. This tool in sales is going to be extremely helpful. So I'm gonna put this to the side. And I'm gonna grab a tool. The video shows cutting open cracks. And so I'm gonna cover this quickly. Almost all concrete has fractures, breaks, or cracks. They need to be addressed individually, really. And most of the time we're looking for cracks that are repairable. I encourage the dialogue as to discover why cracks might have happened. Was it a tree? Or you can ask your client or customer, do you know how this happened? Has it been here since the concrete, was poured? Was it a curing crack? Was there a tree over there? And that problem's been solved. We cut the tree down. We need to investigate and clearly communicate what to expect out of said crack repair. So we use a product called EC72 with our standard system. We also use our epoxy cove gel, EC76, with our decorative systems like custom finish, which I'll show you in a second. But cutting open the crack with a crack chaser diamond blade, I'm gonna show you this, Tori, if you can see this. So this is a crack chaser diamond blade, is a diamond blade typically put on a 4-inch grinder that's in the shape of a V. And it's very aggressive. And as you can see in the video, we're not going to do it right now because we'd be dusted out completely, it's a hot knife through butter. And basically, you chase the crack. You just follow this crack. And you open it up so that you actually are able to put epoxy as a repair down in below the surface of the concrete. You don't just want to butter over the top of the fracture, it's really a feeble attempt at a repair, and it'll break away and it could cause more problems. So this is the proper tool. Now, I get a lot of questions where, can we use a straight blade? Do we have to use a crack chaser? The answer is yes. You can use straight blades on grinders. As long as we are opening up a space for the EC72 or the EC76 to be within the concrete underneath the surface of the concrete. That's what we want. So Mike has a board here that we have simulated cracks in the concrete. Mike, hold this board up for a sec. So quickly, crack chase this, running through these simulated cracks. So then now they're opened up so that we can mix our EC72 and repair this crack. Mike, you ready to go? Okay. So EC72, let me hold that board up for a second, Mike. I want to show you this. EC72 comes in a half-gallon kit or a two-gallon kit, part A and part B. One is gray, one is black. You mix them together, equal parts, until they are consistent color. Todd, I'll take those. But this is the palette. Mike's going to actually mix this up. Thank you, Todd. This is what's a half-gallon kit. The nice thing about the EC72 is they have lids that screw on and off. You can use what you need. Put the caps back on, put them in the truck, take them to the next job. So if you are in this business, I suggest two-gallon kits. Okay, there's a few different ways to do the process or the assembly, if you will, of the crack repair. So we have WP47, which is a fiber lath and 3-inch wide tape by 75 feet. Okay. If it sounds like I'm guessing on that, I was, but I got my Todd here to take care of me. So you can put the epoxy down first and then put the tape over it, pushing the tape into the epoxy. What Mike's doing here is he's cutting the tape to fit the fracture, break, or crack that we've cut open. And then we're going to put the EC72 crack repair directly over the top of the seam tape. Cracks aren't perfect. They don't go in perfectly straight lines. It's not like a joint or an expansion joint. So yes, have a razor knife, and you're going to pull, and as the crack moves and turns, you cut and lay it down. It has a slight adhesive backing, so it's going to stay in place. This epoxy is considered a gel, so to give you some of the consistency here, and you'll be able to see Mike mixing this up. At one time we had a paste form of this product, and it was a different, thicker version of this product. And it turns out that we really didn't need it. And so if anybody's familiar with the, I think it was EC74, that is no longer a product. This product is versatile enough to do both applications that we wanted to, which was, you know, more of a less of a slump. We can patch some vertical stuff, stem walls, etc. So Mike just mixed this thing up on a board pallet. You can mix it in a bucket. It's very simple. And now you have this extremely user-friendly, semi-rigid epoxy. Using a taping knife or a small trowel or margin trowel and embedding it, making sure you're pressing strong enough to go through the fiber lath into the cut and crack, if you will, that you cut open. It is an epoxy. You have about 20 minutes as far as its pot life. So only mix up what you can use and get it on the surface. No time for phone calls, cigarette breaks, don't call your mother. Let's get this done. So as Mike finishes up, I really can't stress the importance of excellent preparation. And one of the questions you may be thinking of is, well, really, do we really need to repair all the cracks? really, it's up to you. What I say is yes. What I write into scope of work specification is repair all the cracks. Cut open all cracks and repair all cracks. We have to be cautious of heaved concrete. When I say heaved is when one piece of the concrete has moved up one side. This may demand a different type of repair. And we do have these cements. We have TC23, which is a mortar cement. This is something that can be used to patch concrete at depth, to patch edges, curbs, cantilever. It's a phenomenal product, and it's in the Westcoat line. So EC72 is down. The specifications call for broadcasting, a little sand on it. You know, it's not so much broadcasting as it is just sprinkling sand on it. The reason for this is, remember, it's epoxy. Epoxies get very hard and smooth very fast. The EC72 will take about 2 to 4 hours to dry. So keeping that in mind as you orchestrate how this job is going to progress in your production of this particular job, your preparation needs to allow for the dry times of all these coats. So a little bit of sand on top of the epoxy as it's wet. So as you go, you might ask, what size sand? Most popular is the 30 mesh. Just having a 30 mesh sand with you when you do all your concrete prep is wise. Pro tip is put it in a small bucket. Don't try and carry around 50-pound or 100-pound bags and spilling them. Put your sand or your broadcast material in smaller buckets. And I'm sure Mark Hain probably covered that in the last EC demo when you're broadcasting chips or quartz. Work out of a bucket and you chicken feed. So same concept here. Mike, let's hold up this board real quick. So we can see it maybe a little better. So this is taking the turkey out of the oven. This is EC72 with the mesh. Now, if you can see, you can still see the honeycomb of the fiber lath, the WP47 3-inch wide tape. And if you feel it, it is gritty. You can feel that. So sweep off your sand. Thanks, Mike. And I'm going to switch places with you because you're going to be on this side. Yes. Now we're going to prime. Yes, we require a primer. It is in the specification to prime the concrete. What Mike is doing is he's using our cement modifier, WP81, mixed with 4 parts water. This is your standard primer. The nice thing about this is it's very cost effective and it dries very, very fast. You can apply coatings almost immediately directly over the top of this. So he poured it out. And he's rolling it on very thin. It has a whiteness to it. It's gonna be a clear primer. Remember, it's 4 parts water at this point. It's introducing this cement modifier, this glue, to the surface of the concrete. Primers help. We also have an option for a more industrial primer. And I am gonna show you that, but I'm also gonna speak to it. It's our EC11 water-based epoxy in clear and 16 colors. Is it still 16 colors, T? 9 standard colors. It was 16. We're sticking with the most popular ones. Got rid of some of the junk we don't sell. So I am going to speak to that. And then here's your pro tip number 2 or 3. Every project that I specify, I go with the industrial primer, EC11. There's a couple ways to put this down. Not to get ahead of myself, we are going to put down EC11 as a primer and broadcast sand in it for the stamp overlay, which is required per spec. But for the Texture-Crete systems, we go, you know, we're not doing a stamp overlay at 1/4 inch. We're doing a much thinner multi-layer system. It's very flexible. So this board is primed. And if you can see a little bit of whiteness to it in the camera. Thank you, Mike. That's what it's going to look like, and it's going to dry within 30 minutes. You can actually trowel product over it. So Mike is going to bring over a couple more boards. We're going to get ready to trowel product right now. I prefer the EC11 back on track. EC11 can be put down. It is an epoxy, but it's a water-based epoxy. So it's not like 100% solids epoxy. In most cases, take 4 to 8 hours to cure. I'm going to move over. The water-based epoxy stays wet in its mass much longer and will dry anywhere, depends on how hot it is, 30 minutes to 4 hours. Spec sheet might say 2 to 4 hours, but we're finding it can dry very fast when it's warmer and going on a warm surface. The EC11 can be put down neat, meaning not diluted with water or solvent. I get that question a lot. What solvent do I dilute the EC11 with? Only water. Remember, it's a waterborne epoxy, water-based epoxy. So you can thin it with water, but if you're going to put sand in it, don't thin it. We call that using it neat. If you're going to trowel product on it that same day, you don't need to broadcast sand in the EC11. I'm going to reiterate that when I show you the EC11. Okay, Mike, you ready? So being a solar reflective specific system, we are going to work with white cements. Mike's taken the WP81, which is cement modifier. It's the same cement modifier that we use 4 parts water in and made a primer out of. He just poured that into a bucket. So that is 1 gallon of WP81. He's going to mix in 2 quarts of water. So the spec, I believe, says you can mix in up to 2 quarts of water. That can be manipulated on the low end of that. We really don't want to go over that 2 quarts of water. So when it's cooler, or you need something stiffer, or you know what? You just like working with a stiffer product, by all means, use a little bit less water. I will tell you this, pro tip, make sure that your mixes are accurate. Make sure that your color addition is precise. You don't want to start manipulating mixes as you move through the project in the driveway or the patio, pool deck, whatever it might be. So Mike, go ahead and mix. I'm going to cover this real quick. It is 1 bag of TC1 white to 1 gallon of WP81 and up to 2 quarts of water. He's using the vacuum to eliminate a lot of the dust. And just to cover, you might have a question on the yield. I'll cover the yields as we go, but I want to make sure the primer board, that 4 parts water, 1 part WP81, you'll achieve about 400 square feet per gallon. Now, this is variable depending on the porosity of your surface, right? So as Mike is mixing this up, Mike, hold that bit up for a second. I want to see that cage bit. We refer to this as a cage bit. I recommend this over every other bit. The second option would be a fan bit. As the fan bit ages over the years, and a lot of you guys might use that, it tends to sharpen. And over the years, I would notice that I'm actually cutting little shards of plastic sometimes into my mix. I like this bit more than any other bit for our cements. Thank you, Mike. Mike is bringing this over to the board or the concrete. And Mallory showed an image of pressure washing concrete. I'll be very honest with you. Most of the time, I would say 70% of the time on exterior concrete coatings, you're going to pressure wash the concrete. You have to investigate. Has there been an existing coating? Has there been anything to seal the concrete or stain the concrete? If not, pressure washing the exterior concrete most of the time will achieve a CSP 2 or 3. So you can see the consistency. Go ahead, Mike. I tell people they're looking for this pancake batter type consistency. Okay, so you can understand really what we're looking for. Troweling a surface. Now, I'll give you another pro tip on this. Always have a small bucket of water and a chip brush close to you. when you're troweling acrylic modified cement, you're probably not going to be in this perfect environment that we are right now. You're going to be out in the sun. You want to be able to, number one, clean your tool, clean your trowel. Clean tools are going to work so much better. When the tools gum up, they're going to leave beads. Now, if you watch Mike, let me steal this for a second. Mike, I want to show one thing. Thanks. We see a lot of people that take a trowel like this. This is what's called a pool trowel. And a pool trowel has a shorter spine and a lot more flexibility in the nose here. When we see beginners, they're troweling more flat like this. When the trowel is flat, if I can demonstrate this, what we want to see is a harder edge, like you saw Mike, but I want to focus on this, and a nose heavy. So thus the pool trowel, but coming in, really diving into your stroke. When we see a lot of the newbies, we see a lot of this pressure right through the middle of the trowel. And what this does, this is referred to, I don't know if this white cement's showing it, but it's a change in elevation, and it's called a trowel mark, as you can see, right over the top of this. We come in and we see trowel marks. Trowel marks are going to make your life more challenging in the next coats. They're bumps in your surface. So I just practice a little bit, practice on boards, just like really what we're doing. I tell contractors that are getting into this industry, go get sheets of masonite or plywood. This is masonite. And practice. You can coat them over and over and over again, but go nose heavy and avoid trowels. Thanks, Mike. So if you watch how he's doing that, it really is going to make a big difference. Mike's very good, very experienced, and he goes very quick. My advice is slow down. Get it right the first time. Because the nicer this coat is, the easier your job is for the next coat. Another pro tip when doing multiple thin coat systems is have floor scrapers, blowers and or brooms or everything, all of above. It's the old Boy Scout, be prepared. Better to have it, not need it, than to need it, not have it. So trowel this slurry coat as flat as you can. Now I wanna touch on something before we keep going is buildup, sloping issues, puddling in front of a door, water is not quite getting to a drain. Again, call your rep, call me. What should I use? We're gonna ask you, how thick, how big of an area? Is there a drain? Do we have something to accomplish in a certain width? And you might say there's standing water right in front of this sliding glass door threshold and it's 7 feet to the side. I need to build up about a half inch to zero. So we have these cements. Actually, you can do it within this product right here, TC1. We also have TC1 gray, which is really the more common of TC1 cements, and it's the most common slurry coat. So when we're referring to a slurry coat, I'm referring to a skim coat, something that's gonna be troweled down as tight as the aggregate will allow, right? Your yield is about 150 square feet per gallon. Now that can go 50 square feet each way. When it comes to sloping, we have a dry polymer cement called TC30. This is something that we've developed over the years. A lot of times we were using our TC1 and backing off the glue and adding 20 pounds of, say, B23 sand for sloping 2 inches to zero. So our cement engineers that work here at Westcoat developed TC30. TC30 is a dry polymer cement. We can go 2 inches to zero by just adding water, right? So this is a part of our slope technique specification. You can find it right on our website. At the end of this, Mallory, actually, after I'm done with this particular system, Mallory's gonna go over some of the website stuff. And maybe we can recall that. But TC30, it's a phenomenal product. I love it. I've used it. It's really everything I am speaking to, I've done with my own hands. And so we like to operate that way, at least I do. You'll find that it's hard for me to go hands off, but that's our TC30 cement. Next thing we're gonna do is we're going to do a texture coat or a smooth, right? With our TC2 cement, also white. Now, why are we using white? We're staying with the white-based products because we are specifically focusing on a solar reflective finish. Let's steal a sample right here. And if I can, if you can see this, this is our standard, maybe right there. See a little bit of reflective light. This is the most common Texture-Crete standard system. We do this, we specify this, our contractors use this product, I would say 90% of the time, right? This is a spray texture through a hopper gun that was shown in our waterproofing demo because it is a standard finish for the ALX system and Matcoat system, but then it's knocked down. So it has this anti-skid knockdown texture. People call it lace texture. I was just handed a better sample to show maybe if I can get this under the proper reflective light. Something right there. See the knockdown texture on this particular half. This is what I'm referring to. Standard knockdown texture. And you can see I'm holding this on a waterproof deck coating sample. This is our Matcoat system for concrete substrates. These finishes can be used on concrete surfaces, very common for patios, pool decks, walkways, driveways. Can you walk on it? Can you drive on it? Absolutely. Okay, Mike, we're ready. Mike is going to mix. This is TC2, white cement. It's a 50-pound bag. As you can see, Mike's back is still good. This is the same mix ratios and products. 1 gallon of WP81 to up to 2 quarts of water, and then a 50-pound bag of TC2 cement. The TC2 is a white cement with much smaller aggregate, so you're not going to be doing buildup or slope with this product. This is going to be troweled much thinner. TC2 can be troweled flat, very flat. Most commonly, it is skip troweled, and we're actually going to show you how we define skip troweling. Again, with the cage bit, you can see his mix station, which is great. Always have plastic. This is the way to set up a mix station. Plastic. Have buckets. Have extra buckets. Have a bucket full of water that you can draw off of. I'm gonna switch sides so you can see Mike Trow. TC2, about the same consistency. There is no specific time that needs to be measured while mixing, but you are looking for that consistency, looking for feel. And we've had guys make mistakes and they leave their bags out in the backyard. They come back over the weekend and it might have gotten wet by the sprinklers. Sometimes that cement will clump up or rock up or lump up. Doesn't mean the product's bad, but make sure you get the rocks out or sift it through a piece of lath or something. Now what Mike's doing is he's troweling this product, again, as tight as the aggregate will allow. Okay, I wanna show you. Again, back to this pro tip. The small bucket, little 1 gallon pail, 2 gallon pail with a little bit of water in it, and your chip brush. I like the 3-inch chip brushes. Really nice, easy to clean your trowel as you go and brush your edges. I'm gonna stand right in front of Mike, he's too handsome. Brushing your edges, brushing the edge of the surface, the driveway, up against where the driveway might meet the garage, joints, expansion joints, control joints. We take the product and we trowel it directly over the concrete joint. And then you take the chip brush and you bury it into the joint, removing the product. So it's just a very thin coat. So we call it honoring expansion joints as you go. We do not want to cover or bridge over permanently expansion joints. They will recrack. And the problem is when they recrack and fracture, they can allow water or moisture into there. And then we refer to it as a cancer of the concrete coating type, but it can do damage from the inside. Water from underneath the surface will create disbonding and degradation, maybe not in the product itself as it was cured, but in the concrete. So I want to address some of the degrading concrete issues. All this needs to be looked at and observed when you go out and look at a job, and then you're going to bid the project. Concrete almost always has fractures, breaks, or cracks. And people say, oh, well, I just poured it. It's brand new concrete, so it's perfect. Brand new concrete can be intimidating as well, right? A lot of curing going on. Mallory mentioned concrete should cure for at least 28 days. That doesn't mean on day 29, it's on my calendar to go encapsulate this thing. We still need to proceed with caution. What's the reason for that? There's a lot of moisture leaving that concrete that's typically 3.5 inches. Mike has brought out a skip trowel texture board. Is that where we're going to do now?
Yep.
So this is what we refer to as a skip trowel. And we're going to show, Mike's going to show how to do this. Yes? Okay, great. Okay, so this board was troweled with TC2 smooth. What we are going to show you now is the skip trowel process. What we have found best practice is to do full coverage. You want to cover every square inch of the surface that you are texturing. As you go, you allow a little bit extra material on your trowel, and you can reach out like Mike is going to do right there, and he's leaving extra texture on this surface. But you want to cover every square inch. Brush your edges, brush your joints, clean your trowel. Good time to clean your trowel is between mixes. This mix will yield you about 125 to 150 square feet per mix. Now, the skip trowel mix is a bag of TC2 mixed with a gallon of WP81 and up to 2 quarts of water. So you can see some of these ridges in here, right through here. Right through here where I'm seeing some of the light. Now, this is still very wet cement, right? This needs to set up a little bit before he can get back on it and be able to re-trowel it, or dare I say hard trowel. We don't want to scuff it. We don't want to discolor it. But appropriately timed, he's going to get back on it. Now, Mike's getting on it a little bit early. It's still wet. But if we were out in the desert doing this, Mike and I would be working, say, hand in hand. He'd be skip troweling, and I would probably have a trowel on a swivel, crazy trowel, standing in the areas where it's going to be flatter, mostly dry, knocking it down, giving it that skip trowel or that slate, that broken slate type appearance. I always tell people, when doing trainings like this, is you really need to be consistent. And I say consistency gets you paid. So if you have any questions on some of the different ways of skip troweling, feel free to ask them. There's a lot of different ways to apply texture to surfaces. I mentioned the knockdown texture, hopper gun. You don't have to knock it down. You can just spray texture. You can use a smaller hole and higher pressure on the hopper gun for a finer texture on the surface and leave it alone. We have contractors that like spray texture with our TC2 cement. It's a little bit finer than our TC3 cement. TC3 cement, we're not going to show you today, but is the most common cement for spraying texture through a hopper gun onto a surface, then knocking it down. So you'll see that in the Texture-Crete standard spec, talks about TC3, 50-pound bag, mixed with a gallon of WP81 and up to 2 quarts of water, right? So the skip trowel texture is on our custom finish specification. We are going to use our SC10 top coat in one of the solar reflective colors called powder blue, correct? So SC10 is 100% acrylic top coat. You put this down. It's on a texture like this, you're probably going to be close to 200 square feet per gallon. I do recommend two coats. Remember, this top coat is going to reduce your temperatures by 20-30% is what we've shown. And on pool decks, out in these hot areas, I mean, San Diego, not to whine about it, but it's been really hot. So, and by really hot, I mean, it was in the 90s. So I'm sure that'll make my friends in the desert real happy that I'm complaining about the 90s. So very common and popular system application here with this skip trowel texture. Believe it or not, it is easier to do a skip trowel texture, in my opinion, than it is to do a really perfectly flat system texture. And I know they kind of contradict each other. A flat, or you know, I'm gonna use the word smooth, texture, because we are referring to the layer that it's being done at, and that is our texture coat. So we'll hold this board up in a minute and show you, if we can, some of the texture. It looks nice. It looks like a slate. You got it, Mike? Let's bring it up, see if we can get a good reflection here. Okay, kind of. I'm going to show you. I'm grabbing some samples here. And Mike, twist that board until you can see a texture in that light. Oh, and you can see how flexible our acrylic modified cements are. So move it like, you know, the nice thing about this is when we have projects where one might be accustomed to doing a spray texture as a standard system, and the skip trowel is really seen as an upgrade, because the custom finish speaks directly to stains over the top, and like we're going to show you in the wood plank system, and then clear sealers. However, you can put a SC10 acrylic top coat, which is this color chart right here, right? The SC10 SR, solar reflective. So the SR stands for solar reflective. And you would choose off of this color chart. I'm going to hold up all the color charts we have for integral color, the water-based stain, and the water-based stain blends. We have these as resources. POS is what we call them for our contractor, point of sale. Also having samples. These are the samples of our SR top coats. They're still called SC10. That's the part number. And if you haven't heard and connected the dots with the four divisions, WP, waterproofing, EC, epoxy coating, SC, surface coat, and TC, texture coat, the part numbers that I'm speaking to go in a very particular division. We also have an accessories division called CA, which I'll speak to in a second. But like the EC72, it's an epoxy, so it's an EC division. SC10 top coat, surface coat, right? So there's our part number along with what it is, 100% acrylic top coat. So we have these color charts. I'll hold it up against my black shirt. Maybe you see it better. Okay, beautiful. So if there's any questions, please bring them to the surface. I'm going to hand this right back to Mallory. She's going to look at the website a little bit. And remember, think of these questions and ask them. There's no better forum than to ask your questions right here, right now. I'm happy to go into detail if I think they might warrant a phone call. I would be happy to personally call you afterwards and go over some of this in greater detail.
Welcome to Westcoat.com. For information on the Texture-Crete solar reflective finish, use the navigation bar and hover over systems. On the right-hand side, under the texture coat line, you will find the Texture-Crete solar reflective finish. The landing page will have pictures, and a link to download the brochure. Below that, you will find a step-by-step illustration of the Texture-Crete solar reflective finish. You'll also find system spec sheets and product spec sheets, including the EC72 Fast Cure Epoxy Patch Gel. You'll also find the color chart, the SC10 Acrylic Top Coats color chart includes our standard colors at the top and the solar reflective series at the bottom. You will notice that the SR gray and SR tan in the bottom right hand corner are the only two colors that are Title 24 Cool Roof rated through the Cool Roof Rating Council. Also on the landing page, you will find self-educated guides and training videos. Up along the navigation bar, you will find the material estimator. The drop-down menu shows all of the systems we offer. When you scroll to the bottom and click on the Texture-Crete solar reflective finish and plug in the square feet, it will give you a calculation of the total materials needed for the entire job and the materials needed for each step in this process on the right. If there is something you're looking for on the Westcoat website that you cannot find, please reach out to us at 800-250-4519 or email us at info@westcoat.com.